Hello everyone, this is Mr. P. In today's lesson, we're going to take a look at sentence starters. Yes, in essay writing. Let's start by first talking about what an essay is. You don't know? Well, I'll give you the answer. An essay is a short piece of writing which is set around a specific topic or subject. This piece of writing will give information about the topic, but it will also give the author's opinion. That's very, very important. So now let's take a look at essay types. There are four important types of essay. There is argumentative essay, which it states and proves a point. Persuasive essay, it tries to convince the audience. Number three is expository essay. It explains something with facts and presents a solution. And number four, narrative essay. It tells a story with a purpose. Now, we have other types of essays. There are less common ones. The one that compares and contrasts essay, and is called compare and contrast essay. Descriptive essay. It puts a picture in your head. And the last one is cause and effect. It explains why and how something happens. Now that you have a clear picture of the essay types, we're going to look at the essay structure. So first, we have an introductory paragraph. Well, the introductory paragraph is subdivided into the following three main points. The first one is the hook. It catches the attention of the reader. Number two, or B, is background information. This can be the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth sentences of your introductory paragraph. The last sentence of your introductory paragraph is the most important one. It's called the thesis statement. If you don't have a thesis statement, you don't have an essay. Number two, body paragraph or body paragraphs. Why do I say that? Because a normal type of essay has three body paragraphs, but there can also be just one body paragraph. It depends on the essay. So the first sentence of your body paragraph is called the topic sentence. The second sentence and the third and the fourth, there can be detailed sentences with examples. And the last sentence of your body paragraph, of course, is called a conclusion sentence. So it draws a conclusion about the topic sentence. Now, the last paragraph of your essay, which can be the third paragraph or the fifth paragraph of your essay, is called the concluding paragraph. And again, it is subdivided in three parts. The first one, it paraphrases the thesis statement. Then we have the summary of the points you talked about in the body paragraphs. And the last point of your concluding paragraph is your opinion, your suggestion, or a prediction you make about the topic you talked about in your essay. Now that we have a clear picture of the structure of an essay, we're going to take a look at the most common sentences for essay use. I divided the sentences into seven groups. The first ones are general sentences. The second group is to introduce ideas or to introduce a topic. The third one is to conclude a paragraph or your idea. The fourth one is to compare and contrast. The fifth one is to give examples. The sixth is to show relationships or outcomes. And the seventh is to present prior or background ideas. Well, seriously? Well, yes, you'll understand, Mr. P. So, first stop, general sentences. Well, hello, Mr. P. Here, we can start a sentence with, it can be argued that. This is the most common one. Another point of view suggests that. It can be seen that. It may be that on the positive side. On the negative side. The next point that I want to mention is to try to avoid sentences that announce what you will discuss in your essay. sentences such as this essay will discuss or this essay will be focused on, etc., etc. So now let's take a look at the second group to introduce. So we can say something like the definition of will be given or is briefly outlined, is explored, etc., etc. The issue focused on is demonstrated, is included. These are all examples, so you can use either or. The key aspect discussed are presented, is justified. Views on range from is evaluated, is examined, or the central theme is described, is analyzed, emphasized are is explained and illustrated with examples. Now, let's take a look at my example sentence. The issue focused on crime is demonstrated on the following points. So now to conclude, we can write a sentence starting with in summary, in brief, to conclude. It has been shown that in conclusion, to sum up, to review, to summarize, thus, hence, in short. So an example could be, in short, crime is at a record low because our police force is at a record high. Group number four, to compare and contrast. Similarly, in comparison, however, and yet, on the contrary, whereas, while this is the case, in the same way, complementary to this, this is in contrast to, nevertheless, on the other hand, in contrast to, disputes, likewise, then again, in contrast, conversely, notwithstanding, that aside, despite this. And my example is, likewise, Detroit has seen violent crime rates experience a general decline since the early 2000s. Now, the next point is to give examples. And here, there are tons of expressions. So, as you can see, okay, I wrote, for example, for instance, specifically, such as, also, furthermore, next, more importantly, than, and so on. I also provided some examples of sentences that can be used not at the beginning but in the middle of a sentence, such as it can be seen in or as demonstrated by. These are all sentences or collocations that we can use when giving examples. My example for this group is, furthermore, crime incidents at Metro are as frequent as disorderly conduct incidents. So let's take a look at the next group, to show relationships. Therefore, hence, the evidence suggests after examining, considering, etc., etc. As you can see, we have also many, many expressions that we can use to show relationship. My example for this group is, considering the nature of the crime, it can be questioned the disproportionate force used to arrest the suspect. Now, the last group. To present background ideas. In the past, customarily, prior to this, previously, conventionally, initially, until now, historically, etc., etc. My example for this group is, in the past, crime in Canada was measured by its effects. Well, that's it for today. Yes, that's me. That's Mr. P. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, any other examples that you can give your fellow classmates, please post them under this video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. If you like the lesson, hit on the like button, please, and you may share the lesson with your fellow classmates. See you soon, see you next time, and good luck with your writing. Take care. Bye-bye.